Your freestyle about Black Lives Matter was a protest to me. And not only was it a protest, it was a hell of a fire protest. I have the lyrics here, and some of them I want to go over, but before I do that, I just want to know, what was your mindset when you said, listen, I mean
my mindset was this. Look, you know what I'm saying? Yo, I'm at an age where I don't need to be out somewhere risking catching the coronavirus to prove a point just to be seen, right? Mm-hmm. That's not what I need to do. But I also need to say something for my people and be there for my people. I think generals have positions, soldiers have positions. You have generals and soldiers. It is what it is.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I felt like I needed to say something that people would feel, you know what I'm saying? And that people could relate to. And I needed to tell the truth. And that's what I did. I wrote it in about 30 minutes and spoke the truth and just gave the world the truth, my truth. You know what I'm saying? And I believe every word I said with every ounce of my heart, and I gave it to him. You know what I'm saying? And it meant everything to me. And when I look at it, you go to my Instagram right now. It got 1.7 million views on Instagram. You go to my Facebook, it got 2.4 million views on Facebook. I mean, that's a lot of people that we have touched. You know what I'm saying? That's four point something million people that have seen that freestyle and engaged in that freestyle and been inspired and motivated by that freestyle. That's me doing my job. You know what I'm saying? That's me stepping up for my culture. That's me doing something for my culture. You know, I'm utilizing modern technology, but I'm doing something for my culture. You know what I mean? And it's the right way to move. It's the right way to do it. I know for an absolute fact that, you know, the Malcolms and Martins would be on IG and would be on these platforms right now doing things and speaking to the people. You know they would. We always got to embrace the technology. So I'm doing my part and I'm continue to do my part. And then, like I told you, rockthebells.com is black owned. But I went and got, you know, I went and made sure that we got investment from the culture. Mark Cuban invested. He don't run the show. He invested. He was willing to invest. Skip Gates from Harvard invested. Bazoma St. John invested. My man Glenn Hutchins, you know what I'm saying, invested. You know, Jeff Yang invested. So I'm making sure that I'm doing this thing right for our people. And then I'm redirecting all of them funds and all of the different people that they invested and turning around and taking rockthebells.com and making it black owned for us. That's for us. Look, let me keep it 1,000. Like, I don't need to do that to I'm all right.
Bro.
Okay. I just want to clear one thing up. People ain't seen me on the cover of the Forbes, but rest assured, your boy's okay. All right?
Right.
So what I'm saying is, when I do these things, I'm doing it for a reason. And it ain't only just for money. The real reason is because I believe that we got to control our narrative. History is written by the winners.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So we got to support each other and love each other and do right by each other. You know what I'm saying? And so, yeah, I'll write a rhyme when I mean it. I didn't sell it. I just said it because it meant something to me. I was inspired. And that's what it's about for me. You know what I mean?
I mean, listen, we know for a fact. I didn't even have to look up your net worth to already know what it is. You've been doing this since the 80s. Even if you would have blown your money, you still had three decades to get it back. But on another level, you're on a hit TV show, one of the top 20 in America in general. That's the people, I want you to understand that. This man is on one of the top 20 shows in the nation in general. Were you nervous to take a stand like that? Were you nervous that CBS would step to you about it?
Well, listen, I think you got to tell the truth, right? Like, I'm not cocky, all right? I do business with people, but I would hope that when people that I do business with see the things I say and do, they feel proud. I would hope that they say, you know what? There's a guy that cares about his people. There's a guy that's willing to stand up and man up. I would hope that they say, yo, we love how you represent. Because it's not about, I ain't trying to demonize nobody. I told the truth. You know, and the truth is a real thing. And we got a righteous, just cause with this situation. We got a righteous, just cause, man. It ain't like I'm just, you know, talking out my ass. We got a righteous cause with this. You know, we are telling the truth. Like the situations that are going on and the way some of these officers are treating us is out of control.
It's crazy.
It's outrageous.
Crazy.
And so, come on. Like, I can't, I'm not going, what I'm going to do, like, just be, you know, I can't do that because that's a sellout, right? It's not, it doesn't mean that I'm going to be as foul as I possibly can be and try to alienate the people I'm in business with. I don't move like that, but that's just foolishness. But I'm going to tell the truth. I'm going to be there for my people. You know, I know that I have a public platform and I know that I'm at a level where people look to me for inspiration. So I know I need to say something. I know that I don't need to just disappear because they want to hear from me. Because it makes them feel better because I'm somebody that they grew up with over 30 years of their lives and they look to me and wonder what L thinks. So I speak on it. You feel me?
That makes perfect sense to me. Number one, has anybody said anything to you? And number two, what are your biggest aspirations for Black Lives Matter and the protests that we've had?
Everything I've gotten has been positive. You know, for the most part. I mean, sure, I'm sure if we were to go sift through the internet, we could find something negative, but that's everything, right?
No, I mean, the people in power.
I know what you're saying. It's all been positive. It's all been positive energy because it came from a truthful and positive place, you know? And, you know, I haven't, you know, luckily, by the grace of God, I'm not in business with those. I haven't been in business with those type of people. Like, the people I've been working with seem to be inspired by it. And seem to appreciate the fact that I'm on that page and I'm willing to be a man and stand up for my people. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, it hasn't been any issues. And then, you know, and then what was the second part of the question?
What are your biggest aspirations for Black Lives Matter? And what are your biggest fears about Black Lives Matter?
Well, my aspirations are for Black people. You know what I mean? I support Black Lives Matter. You know, I know that they different people have different things to say, but ultimately for me, it's about our people just getting on getting equal footing in America, right? So that we can have, you know, equal opportunity on every level and not to be, you know, to no longer be marginalized and pushed to the side. That's how I think about it. In terms of fears and concerns, the key, you know, I don't even operate in a place of fear. I don't really take counsel of fears. If there's something that I have a fear or concern about, I make a move to try to lessen the probability of it happening. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. You feel me? If I was allergic to strawberries and I had a fear that, you know, I was going to go to this restaurant, they were going to have strawberries everywhere, I would get people to call ahead and figure it out and make sure that there's no strawberries in the building. You know, mm-hmm. I wouldn't be sitting there nervous. You see what I'm saying? So I don't know that I have any fears. What I would say is we just have to keep up the momentum. That's
my fear. We need the momentum to continue to grow because we now have the pressure on. If we keep the pressure on, we can make changes. But if 100%. We just forget about it, and it's sports tomorrow, it's this the next day, who knows what happens?
Yeah. You know, I think that you gotta stay committed. This is a marathon. It is a marathon. And you know, like a lot of times, like what people don't realize is if the playing field is zero, you know, we're starting from the negative. You know, so before we start getting here, yeah, some of us have gotten at it up here, but a lot of us are still below zero. So we gotta raise up this community. And that's gonna come through thinking. That's gonna come through, you know, you know, how we approach the world, holding people accountable. We got to vote. Yo, they got to vote. Yes. All this, yo, like this idea that, you know, that, oh, my vote don't count. It's like, yo, if you don't think your vote counts, everybody who doesn't vote because they don't think their vote counts is voting for Trump.
I was told that.
Bottom line.
Somebody said to me, a vote for a Republican is a vote for a Republican. But if you don't vote as a Democrat or whatever you are, it's a vote for Trump. Bottom line.
Without a doubt. I'm an independent. I'm an independent because I don't want nobody telling me what to do. You know what I'm saying? That's how I move. I'm an independent. Like, I remember there was all these rumors, all LL's a Republican. I ain't no Republican. That's bullshit. I'm an independent. You know what I'm saying? I vote for who I want to vote for. I ain't voting for Trump. It's not happening. You know what I'm saying? I ain't telling, yo, people got to vote for who they want to vote for, but I'm not voting for him. You know what I mean? Well, it's like, you got to pick, when you get out there, you got to, you guys gotta, you gotta vote, man. You gotta vote. That it don't, it does matter. Even if you don't think it matters, if it don't matter, vote anyway. How about that? You say it don't matter, so don't vote. So vote. It's like a little pill, right? It's like a little pill. You say, oh, that medicine don't work. All right, well, take it anyway.
Take it anyway.
Because you said it don't work. So in case it does, here, take it. Look at the vote. Look at the vote as a little medicine. All right, a little pill. You don't think the pill works? Vote anyway. Right. And then we'll see what happens.
For me, again, like you said, you're right. We're right on in the same space. I'm not a Democrat. I'm not a Republican. I'm an independent. I'm for the truth, whatever it happens to be, and I'm going to move accordingly. We're dealing with two big things in the world right now, coronavirus and racism. You can only eradicate one, coronavirus or racism. Which one do you pick and why? Fat Man Scoop.